Good afternoon. My name is Henry Mann. I'm the Dean of the College of Pharmacy, and it is my honor to serve as your Master of Ceremonies today. I am pleased to open this doctoral convocation and white coat ceremony for the PharmD class of 2026. This is a particularly special moment for me, as I told you a few days ago. This will be my last occasion of being the Master of Ceremonies for the White Coat Ceremonies, as it's my last year as the Dean of the College. And I'm so happy to be here with you today. I wish to extend my warmest welcomes to the family, friends, and guests here this afternoon. And of course, let's join together in offering a warm welcome to the class of 2026, whom we celebrate today and induct through this ceremony as student pharmacist. While some of you have been in our classrooms and walked our campus as undergraduate students, others are here at The Ohio State University for the first time. No matter where you are from, all of you will be bonded from this time forward as the Doctor of Pharmacy class of 2026. This year, we have also adopted the theme, Pharmacy Buckeyes Building Community, as we transition more holistically back to the classroom and back to campus after 2 years of virtual and hybrid offerings. Inclusive community building helps to increase connection, and we are working to foster a greater sense of belonging within the college. Originally, this was an initiative we were pursuing for our students, but community building involves all of us. As I mentioned earlier this week, my door is always open, and I encourage you to get involved in the college, meet new classmates, and try new things. During your transition course, you'll become familiar with our PharmD curriculum, the professional experience program, study skills, and strength finding sessions. In short, you will see that your next 4 years are not only busy, but clearly charted. Today, we take this brief moment in time to symbolize your passage into the initial stages of the pharmacy profession. And we make the commitment to each other to provide compassionate patient care over the course of our careers. The white coat ceremony is an important tradition in academic health science centers, and it is primarily found in colleges of pharmacy and medicine. The first white coat ceremony began in 1993 at the Columbia University College of Physicians and Surgeons. The first pharmacy school to hold a white coat ceremony was my alma mater, the University of Kentucky, in 1995. White coat ceremonies are now commonplace in pharmacy schools in the U.S. Here at The Ohio State University, this is our 24th white coat ceremony. This tradition is meant to emphasize that the need for personal duty and professionalism goes hand in hand with high academic excellence. The white coat that you put on today symbolizes the need to possess not only the scientific knowledge and technical skills required of a pharmacist, but also the understanding and compassion to provide pharmacy care and services for patients. The white coat reinforces the notion that professionalism is something that we live by, and it embodies mutual respect, honest communication, compassion, and a shared humanity. And for you, members of the PharmD class of 2026, the white coat marks your transition to student pharmacist. Congratulations again. It is my pleasure to introduce a great friend and colleague to provide this afternoon's keynote address, your class advisor, Dr. Jennifer Rodas. Dr. Rodas is the Associate Dean for Outreach and Engagement and Professor of Clinical Pharmacy in the Pharmacy Practice and Science Division. She is also the Vice President of the Ohio Pharmacists Association Board of Trustees. She received her Doctor of Pharmacy degree from Ohio Northern University and is a graduate of the Community Ambulatory Care Residency at The Ohio State University College of Pharmacy. Dr. Rodas created Partner for Promotion in 2005 and has served as director since its initiation. This nationally recognized program joins students and community-based pharmacy practitioners to develop and implement advanced patient care services. She has facilitated the adoption of PFP at 8 colleges of pharmacy across the U.S. since 2009. Her areas of focus include advancing pharmacy practice through empowering current and future pharmacists to develop and sustain pharmacist-provided patient care, and to contribute to the advancement of the profession of pharmacy practice. Dr. Rodas is the recipient of the American Pharmacists Association Academy of Pharmacy Practice and Management Distinguished Pharmacy Practice Award, the American Association of Colleges of Pharmacy Innovations in Teaching Award, and the Ohio Pharmacists Association Beal Award. Under 40 recognition and key awards, Dr. Rodas also led Ohio State to receive the AACP Lawrence C. Weaver Transformative Community Service Award in 2017. We are honored to have Dr. Rodas join us today and share her insight with our upcoming class. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Jennifer Rodas.
Thank you for that kind introduction, Dean Mann, and thank you for the opportunity to give the address today. Thank you also to the wonderful staff and faculty on the stage this afternoon and to the audience here today. You are all so important to what this day represents. A special call out to the friends, family, and loved ones who are present, as well as those joining us through the live stream and here in spirit, to show support for these incoming students. Welcome, class of 2026, to the Ohio State University College of Pharmacy and to the next phase of your journey within the profession of pharmacy. Today is a day of celebration, and as with any milestone event, I suggest that today be a day to not only celebrate, but also to reflect. You'll soon find out that we value self-awareness that comes through reflection and goal setting to help you achieve your version of success. Reflection involves consideration of where you've been and who you've been, an awareness of how you have grown through your past experiences to get to where you are and who you are now, and analysis and insight to guide you forward with what you will do and who you will be. I have three messages and related advice that I will ask you to consider as you reflect today. One, find your people. Two, you do you and honor others doing them. And three, use your resources. I entered the profession more than 20 years ago as a first-generation college student. I had no real plan for my future, and never would I have imagined that I'd be standing here in front of you today. As I reflect back on my experiences, consider my present, and gaze into my hazy road ahead, there's one consistency of all the influential factors in my life that have brought me to this point. That which has buoyed me and kept me afloat, propelled me forward, and lifted me up are the people and relationships in my life. My community. These have been personal and professional and quite often blur the lines, as my colleagues are often my friends and vice versa. I have found my people in a few key ways, and I want to share those with you to help you consider ways to build your community in this next phase of your life. First and foremost, there's the foundation of my loved ones, family and friends. These folks have known me through many life events and transitions and have been important as comrades walking with me on my journey. You already have these folks. I encourage you to keep them close and value them to keep you grounded in the why that brought you here, to provide listening ears outside of pharmacy school, and to make you laugh. Joy and laughter are absolutely necessary for resilience and success. Next, there are the professional colleagues that I have gained through my time in pharmacy school and postgraduate training. These are mentors, educators, classmates with whom I have transformed into the professional that I am today. They understand me in a special way. As we have been learning together for over 20 years, I encourage you, get to know your faculty and your classmates, in your class as well as those ahead of you and behind you at the Ohio State College of Pharmacy. These folks not only understand the day-to-day struggles and opportunities in your pharmacy world, but they can connect you and provide recommendations for new opportunities. I assure you, you will learn more with these folks than alone. I have classmates today that unexpectedly, if I'm being honest, are managers, directors, faculty members, business folks in industry, pharmacy owners and providers of fantastic patient care in all different settings, who I sat next to in the lecture hall 20 years ago, commiserated with about tough exams and professors, and spent time with outside of the academics. They call me now about former students of mine they're considering hiring to get the inside scoop, and we meet up at professional meetings. Some of these folks are still my best friends. Because of our time spent building community in pharmacy school, we are still a community, one that is spread out across the state and nation, and we pick up right where we left off when our paths cross with trust and collegiality, and some shared stories that we promise not to repeat in professional settings. Finally, I've added to my community through professional organizations, from the Ohio Pharmacists Association, one of our state organizations, for which I'm honored to be currently serving as vice president, to national professional organizations. The connections I've made at annual meetings and through being a member have been invaluable. They have elevated the care I've provided to patients as well as my teaching and research through learning from others who are working in similar spaces. I encourage you to learn about the student professional organizations available to you here at Ohio State and get involved in the exciting work of our state associations. The connections in these spaces will not only build your growth as a professional, but they're going to link you to jobs, to scholarships, to awards, and to training opportunities that you may not otherwise encounter. I think about my community like a constellation. Each person is a star, unique. Some are similar to me, and we connect on a variety of levels, and it's tempting to create a community with like-minded folks who are a lot like you. It's comfortable, it's welcoming, it's easy, and I hope you don't do this. Of course, I want you to find those folks with whom you easily connect, but also purposefully seek out those who are different from you in their priorities, what their experiences have been, and how they approach the world. Get comfortable being uncomfortable. I promise you, you will find surprising similarities and mutual understandings with some of these folks as well. From having this diversity in my community, I've grown in ways I could not have otherwise comprehended. I value the individuality of each of the stars in the constellation community of my life, and I recognize the important role that I play in the constellations of others. The best thing I can do for those in my life is to show up as my authentic self and honor them showing up as them. With that, I would like to lean in for a moment to the you do you part of my message. For the folks in the room who are uncertain about this term, I want to show legitimacy of what may seem like a slang term by sharing the definition put forth by the Yale Grammatical Diversity Project, available online. The phrase means, quote, be yourself or do what you want. And it is typically identified with contemporary youth millennial culture and vernacular, end quote. The first attestations of this phrase, you do you, can be traced back to the turn of the century. And yes, parents and grandparents and family members of a certain age, I am talking about the 1900s to the 2000s turn of the century, when many of the class of 2026 may have been taking their first steps. This first attestations can be traced back to the turn of the century in hip-hop, such as the track Do You by Funkmaster Flex featuring DMX. In this track, you will hear DMX talk about everyone having their own talent and voice. DMX also raps about honoring everyone's individuality. Not only do I encourage you to do you, but create space for and learn from others doing them. You can YouTube the pretty great live performance of this after today's event by searching Funkmaster Flex featuring DMX 2000. My main message around you do you and honor others doing them, and what I want you to really carry forward, is that you are valuable and you are enough. Every single one of you. You may be looking around here today wondering if you fit here, if you're going to be able to do this, or how much better prepared others might be that are sitting around you. And some of you are thinking, what is she talking about? I am awesome and gonna rock this. The reality is that no matter who you are and how you feel today, you will have a moment sometime during your pharmacy career when you will wonder if you can do this, if you are enough. And so I am telling you here today that you, as the person you authentically are, you are enough. And those folks sitting around you, walk with them on their individual journeys. You are all going to do this pharmacy school thing differently. Honor each person's distinctive approach and perspective, and that will make you stronger as individuals, professionals, and a class. The most successful students, and I say success, meaning the ones who reach a career that is meaningful to them, the most successful students reflect on who they are and who they want to be regularly. They seek out broad communities of colleagues and friends inside and outside of pharmacy and the college, and they share their authentic talents and voice, value the perspectives of others, and they use their resources. Cue message number 3, use your resources. The resources I am talking about may be faculty, counseling services, student services, colleagues, mentors, or any other of the numerous options available to you here at Ohio State. You have learned about some or many of them during orientation, and it might feel just a touch overwhelming right now. Please know that this community is here to help you find what you need and navigate the opportunities as you do you here at Ohio State. As you reflect on this day and this moment of transition in your lives and officially receive your white coat, think about where you are now and who you want to be moving forward as a professional, as a pharmacist, and honoring your authentic self. I will wrap up with a reminder of my 3 key messages. Find your people. Build your community broadly and seek connections with those who are different from you. The sky is more beautiful with constellations of unique stars. You do you and honor others doing them. As you build that community, do so as your authentic self with your own voice and value others as they show up. Remember, you are enough. Use your resources. You have so much available to you through our college, the university, professional organizations, and beyond. Reflect on where you are and where you want to go, who you are and who you want to be, and know we are here to help you navigate the resources to support you on your journey. Welcome, class of 2026, to the next step of your professional journey here at the Ohio State University College of Pharmacy. I hope you enjoy today's celebration. Thank you so much.
Dr. Rodas, thank you for your inspiring words and for being with us today. Now to the main event, presentation of the white coats. I would like to invite Isabel Claremont, a third-year PharmD candidate and mentor, to share some words on the student mentors who will provide the white coats today. She will be followed by Megan Sayers, Program Director of Professional Studies, to announce the members of our incoming class. Isabel?
Thank you. As Dean Mann indicated, my name is Isabel Claremont, and I am currently serving as one of the mentors for the incoming class. In 2013, students within the College of Pharmacy's chapter of ROCHI, a pharmacy honor society, set the goal of establishing a formal mentoring program to pair each incoming student with an upper class mentor. Since then, this program has continued as a vital part of each class's transition into pharmacy school. Mentors help incoming students adjust to the rigorous curriculum of a professional program, explore student organizations and extracurricular activities, and even provide insight on fun things to do around Columbus. Now, in its 9th year, the mentor program has been reimagined as part of the college's Peer Leader Scholars program. This inaugural program provides leadership and interpersonal skill development to help us as mentors positively contribute to the experience of our fellow students. Today, our incoming students will be presented their white coats by their mentor. Students are a part of a mentor group that met throughout orientation this week and will continue to engage during their P1 year. We serve as mentors because we want to help our classmates and our pharmacy school as smoothly as possible. Many of us shared the positive impact that our mentor had on us as new P1 students, and we are excited to do this for this year's incoming class. Please join me now in a round of applause for our mentors.
Good afternoon. My name is Megan Sayers, and as the Program Director of Professional Studies, it is my privilege to lead the presentation of the White Coats and announce the members of the Doctor of Pharmacy class of 2026 joining us today. Each student will be called individually on stage to be coated with their white coat. Students, as you're introduced, please cross the stage to meet your mentor at the center and hand them your white coat. Stand facing the audience, and your mentor will be standing behind you to coat you. After being coated, please walk to the right to pose for a headshot, and then return to your seat. Audience, please clap for your student after they are coated, and then we will conclude with applause for the entire class. We will now begin with the presentation of the white coat. Ayomide Alabi. Russia Alamari. Aisho Salim Ali. Caitlin Nicole Arbaugh. Sarah Augustine. Madeline Taylor Barnett. Mackenzie Bosman. Tegan Benedict. Mac Lee Bentley. Andrew Berger. Romina Isabella Biswas. Allison Beauvaird. Elizabeth Brown. Morgan Sazierski. Kaylee Ann Clark. Cassandra Koblenz. Mackenzie Rose Cordosi. Vidi Daga. Jarrett Drucker. Peter Elgin. Jason Ezekobi. Molly Anguku Fendru. Alyssa Fico. Madeline Fitchrow. Kyle Matthew Foltz. Chandler Gibbs. Spencer Griffiths. Maya Guznicek. Reem Adabagi Hassan. Jennifer Hong. Jora Hu. Deborah S. Epenmenrodi. Emily Ivanoff. Jason Jama. Maimuna Jarju. Hannah Elizabeth Johnson. Jordan Johnson. David Joseph. Jasmine Kainth. Jesse Coe. Tiffany Coe. Blaze R. Kohler. Aiden Kolb. Kate Lauren Krieger. Mason Edward Light. Sharon Liu. Braden Loveless. Matthew Joseph Lucas. Ava Marzo. Lucinda McBride. Michael Bolton. Autumn Nickel. For Dealey in Chicago. Woo! Melissa Ofori. Marvelous Odeoye Olokeri. Maggie O. Jill Patel. Yeah! Krishna Patel. Meet Patel. Gage Gebhardt Paul. Lauren Ann Peel. Jamie Pettit. Abigail Celeste Petty. Kevin Fan. Tiffany Quash. Amanda Rimeter. Samira Rezwan. Austin Riddle. Dana Roby. Gunnar Rose. Mohand Sakran. Madeline Scarfo. Christina Sherman. Colin Smaldenst. Emma Seals. Brock Smith. Sarita Kiyong Smith. Kaylee Steele. Marina Stevens. Sydney Taylor Stevens. Alyssa Swank. Shayla Ta. Sheridan Tassi. Olivia Ann Taylor. Leanne Trin. Bryce Ulup. Brittany Candace Upperman. Olivia Vecina. Megan Jime Wong. Claire Wallet. Housen Wu. Katie Zhe. Olivia Opong Yeboa. Clark Claire Alana Johan. Camelia Chelsea Uwaya. Monica Zeiler. Please join me in welcoming the Doctor of Pharmacy class of 2026 to the Ohio State University College of Pharmacy. Give them another round of applause. Let's give them one last round of applause.
Thank you. As our students don their white coats, they symbolically accept the responsibilities inherent to the profession of pharmacy, as will be exemplified in their recitation of the Student Pledge of Professionalism. We implore you to take these responsibilities seriously so as to bring honor to yourself, your college, and your profession. Kat Sparrow is a third-year PharmD candidate and an important student leader in our college, currently serving as president of the Pharmacy Council. Kat will lead the class of 2026 in reciting the Student Pledge of Professionalism. Kat.
Thank you, Dean Mann. As the dean indicated, my name is Kat Sparrow, and I'm honored to be leading you in the pledge this afternoon. If the members of the incoming Doctor of Pharmacy class of 2026 could please recite along with me the Pledge of Professionalism, which appears on screen and is printed in your program. I will start by reading the first paragraph alone, then please join me in reading the five bullet points that follow. I will conclude by reading the final paragraph alone. As a student of pharmacy, I believe there is a need to build and reinforce a professional identity founded on integrity, ethical behavior, and honor. This development, a vital process in my education, will help to ensure that I am true to the professional relationship I establish between myself and society as I become a member of the pharmacy community. Integrity will be an essential part of my everyday life, and I will pursue all academic and professional endeavors with honesty and commitment to service. To accomplish this goal of professional development, as a student of pharmacy, I will develop a sense of loyalty and duty to the profession by contributing to the well-being of others and by enthusiastically accepting the responsibility and accountability for membership in the profession. Foster professional competency through lifelong learning. I will strive for high ideals, teamwork, and unity within the profession in order to provide optimal patient care. Support my colleagues by actively encouraging personal commitment to the oath of a pharmacist and the code of ethics for pharmacists as set forth by the profession. Dedicate my life and practice to excellence. This will require an ongoing reassessment of personal and professional values. Maintain the highest ideals and professional attributes to ensure and facilitate the covenantal relationship required of the pharmaceutical caregiver. The profession of pharmacy is one that demands adherence to a set of ethical principles. These high ideals are necessary to ensure the quality of care extended to the patients I serve. As a student of pharmacy, I believe this does not start with graduation. Rather, it begins with my membership in this professional college of pharmacy. Therefore, I will strive to uphold this pledge as I advance toward full membership in the profession. I voluntarily make this pledge of professionalism. Thank you and congratulations on the start of your professional student career.
Thank you for your service to our college, Kat. I would also like to thank Dr. Rodas and Megan for their words today. A special thank you to our College of Pharmacy alumni for providing the white coats and notes of advice for our students and the associations who provided welcomes in the printed program. Lastly, thank you to the faculty and staff here today, especially members of the Office of Academic Affairs, who worked very hard to bring about this ceremony. Let's give them a hand. This now concludes the doctoral convocation and white coat ceremony for the PharmD class of 2026. I ask that family and guests remain seated while our students process out of the auditorium to pose for a class photograph. Afterwards, families and guests can meet their students outside on the plaza to enjoy campus for the remainder of the evening. Congratulations to the student pharmacist of the class of 2026. Thank you.
Thank you.